and offer arti to Prabhupada Samadhi, at that time they sing the Guru Vastika prayer.
Krishna 的名字是非常有力量的，每天在闻道众的神庙，他们清晨给帕帕德唱巴颂吟诗，是在他的萨玛里唱巴颂吟诗。
And then after the arti of Prabhupada Samadhi, then everyone goes into the temple of Krishna Balaram. And so we just sang the Guru Vastika, we just sang the Guru Vastikam, so we don't sing it again, we sing this Vibhavarishesh.
因为在帕帕德萨玛里做阿提的时候呢，奉献者已经唱了Guru Vastikam，接着去进入主庙的时候就不再唱这首歌，而唱了Vibhavarishesha这首歌曲。It's
a song which was written by Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. And it was always sung in the temples of the Gaudiya Math in the times of Bhaktisiddhanta
Saraswati.
Nidra-tari-yota-jeeva Bolo Hari Hari Mukunda Morari Rama Krishna Hayagriva
Bolo Hari Hari Mukunda Morari
Bolo Hari Hari Mukunda Morari Rama Krishna Hare Krishna
Bolo Hari Hari Mukunda Morari Rama Krishna Hare Krishna
Nasimhavamana, Rajendra Nandana
Shama
Nasimhavamana Jaya Utana Tatana, Kaikava Tatana, Jaya Tatana, Jaya
Tatana,
Yashoda Lala, Govinda Gopala, Vrindavana Purandara. Yashoda Lala, Govinda Gopala, Vrindavana
Yashodhana, Kamsani, Shudhana, Nikunjana,
Yashodanam dhamma amsani shudham nikunjata vipasi
Thank you.
namo bhagavate vasudevaya
om namo bhagavate vasudevaya
Continuing to read Srimad Bhagavatam, we're on canto number 4, chapter 21, instructions given to Maharaj Prithu. Text number 5. Sankha
Sankha
Dundubhi
Dundubhi
Goshena
Goshena
Brahma
Brahma
Goshena
Goshena
Chakrijam
Chakrijam
Vivesha
Vivesha
Bhavanam
Bhavanam
Vira
Vira
Suryamano
Suryamano
Gata,
Gata,
Smaya,
Smaya,
Shankha Dundubhi Goshenha,
Shankha Dundubhi Goshenha,
Brahma Goshena Chatvijam,
Brahma Goshena Chatvijam,
Vivesha Bhavanam Vira,
Vivesha Bhavanam Vira,
Suryamano Gatasmaya
Suryamano Gatasmaya
Shankha Dundubhi Goshena
Shankha Dundubhi Goshena
Brahma Goshena Chatvijam
Brahma Goshena Chatvijam
Vivesha Bhavanam Vira
Vivesha Bhavanam Vira
Suryamano Gatasmaya
Suryamano Gatasmaya
Shankha Dundubhi Goshena
Shankha Dundubhi Goshena
Brahma Goshena Chatvijam
Brahma Goshena Chatvijam
Vivesha Bhavanam Vira
Vivesha Bhavanam Vira
Suryamano Gatasmaya
Suryamano Gatasmaya
Shankha Dundubhi Goshena
Shankha Dundubhi Goshena
Brahma Goshena Chatvijam
Brahma Goshena Chatvijam
Vivesha Bhavanam Vira
Vivesha Bhavanam Vira
Suryamano Gatasmaya
Suryamano Gatasmaya
Shankha Dundubhi Goshena
Shankha Dundubhi Goshena
Brahma Goshena Chatvijam
Brahma Goshena Chatvijam
Vivesha Bhavanam Vira
Vivesha Bhavanam Vira Suryamano Gatasmaya
Shankha Dundubhi Goshena
Shankha Dundubhi Goshena
Brahma Goshena Chatvijam
Brahma Goshena Chatvijam
Vivesha Bhavanam Vira
Vivesha Bhavanam Vira
Suryamano Gatasmaya
Suryamano Gatasmaya Shankha Dundubhi Goshena
Brahma Goshena Chatvijam
Brahma Goshena
Chatvijam Vivesha Bhavanam Vira
Vivesha Bhavanam
Vira Suryamano Gatha
Suryamano Gatasmaya
Shankha Dundubhi Goshena
Shankha Dundubhi Goshena
Brahma
Professional reciters offered different prayers. But in spite of all this ceremony to welcome him, the king was not the least bit affected.
译文, 当君王进入宫殿时,
君王丝毫不被所动。Wherefore, by His divine grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. The reception given to the king was full of opulence, yet he did not become proud. It is said, therefore, that great personalities of power and opulence were never proud, and the example is given that a tree which is full of fruits and flowers does not stand erect in pride, but instead bends downwards to show submissiveness. This is the sign of the wonderful character of great personality.
要求的声音却没有提高。尽管对君王的迎接富丽堂皇，但他并没有因此而变得骄傲。所以说，真正的强而有力且富有的伟大人物从不骄傲，就好比结满花朵的树木不会傲慢地直挺挺地站着，而是弯下身展现谦逊的姿态，这是伟大的人物所具有的美好品德的展现。
Om Magyana Timarandasya Gyananjana Salakaya Satsuru Nirvana Dasmai Shri Guruve Namaha Shri Taitanya Manolishtam Satikam Yena Bhutare Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati SwaparantikamVandiyam Shri Guru Shri Yata Pada Kamalam Shri Guru Vaishnavasya Shri Rupam Sarajatam Sahajana Rajana Tantikam Kamsatevam Sarvaitam Savadutam Parijana Saitam Krishna Chaitanya DevamShri Radha Krishna Padam Sahajana Lalita Shri Vishakha Miramamaya Hey Krishna Rana Siddho Dina Bandho Jagatpate Lokesha Obhika Kanta Rata Kanta Namastate Tapta Kanta Nohalange Radhe Vrindavane Shwani is describing the activities, the glorious activities of Maharaj Prithu. Just recently I was studying the Sri Ishopanishad with a class, and in Mantra 17 of the Sri Ishopanishad, it mentions the 9 different angas of Bhakti Yoga.
最近我在学习学一修帕米舍制作奥义书，在师节时期当中讲到了奉外瑜伽的九个安格。
I'm sure the Prabhupada goes on to explain how one can practice even one of these processes and achieve perfection.
师的话他解释说，即便是只是修习其中的一个方面，也能达到完美。
And then he explains different personalities who each achieve perfection by practicing one of the 9 processes.
圣帕帕德接着解释说，他就每一个修习的这个分支的代表人物是谁。
And he mentions how Maharaj Prithu is an example of someone who achieved perfection simply by worshipping the Supreme Lord.
而 Maharaj Prithu 是那位仅仅是靠崇拜主就达到完美的代表。
You're gonna have to be a bit quieter, otherwise you sit at the side. You want to sit at the front. So then somebody said to me that they didn't know who Maharaj Prithu was. They'd never heard of him.
然后有人呢就跟马尔说，他们从来没听说过慧度这个人物，他是谁呀？
So Maharaj Prithu is described here in this fourth canto, and it's described how he was churned from the body of the dead king Vena.
在圣经《波迦瓦坛》第四篇当中就描述了慧度当 他是因为维纳王他的维纳王的死尸搅拌他的死尸能诞生出他。
Maharaj Vena was a demonic king who was cursed by the Brahmanas to die.
Maharaj Vena 是一个邪恶的君王，受到婆罗门诅咒而死去了。
But after his death, there was no one to become the king.
但他死了之后呢，没有人继承王位。
But fortunately, they had not burned the body of Maharaj Vena.
有幸是他们并没有焚烧 Maharaj Vena 的尸体。
Because they understood that Maharaj Vena was coming in the line of the great devotee Dhruva Maharaj.
因为他们明白 Vena 王他是诞生在 Dhruva 大军的这个家系当中。
And therefore there was some great spiritual potency there. Although he was a demon, that is, there were some definite.Spiritual power there in the dead body.
尽管他是一个维纳王室的恶魔，但是他的死尸却还是有灵性的力量的。
So after removing some of the bad elements from the body of Maharaj Vena, then they produced Maharaj Preeti.
在把 Maharaj Vena 王的尸体的一些不利因素去除掉之后，他们就。
And Maharaj Prithu went on to restore the condition of the earth, which had been destroyed so much by the demonic King Vena.
Prithu 国王呢，随后他就可以重建由于 Vena 王他的统治带来的给地球带来的灾难。
So Srimad Bhagavatam describes about the rule of.These great personalities and how they could greatly improve the condition of the planet.
顺便，博伽瓦坛就描述了种种这些伟大、强而有力的君王的统治，他们得以维系整个星球的秩序。
So Maharaj Prithu, he came at a time when the planet was in a very deplorable condition.
所以推土国王的降临的时代呢，当时地球上是处在一种很不幸悲惨的状态。
Crops were not growing, the whole planet was ruined.
做庄稼也颗粒不收，整个星球都被毁灭了。
But it was Maharaj Prithu who came and restored condition. One of the things which he did was he leveled the earth.
然而普利图国王降临得以重建秩序，其中的一个丰功伟绩是他把地球给削平了。
Just like if you go to Mayapur, there's a place in Mayapur which is just beside the home of Murari Gupta. When you come from the Yoga Peak and you come along the road towards our ISKCON temple, then there's one temple to Murari Gupta, and on that way you can see there's a level.That area is called Prithu Kund.
当我们就是在麻坡经过有一个地方叫 Murari Gupta 他的地方，然后在从经过他可以到 Yoga Peak， 然后在经过的路上呢有一个很平坦的地方叫 Prithu Kund.
And they said Maharaj Prithu had created a kund there, which was very.Helpful for all the local farmers to irrigate the fields.
他们说，奎土王、奎土国王，创建了、挖掘了这个湖，得以让这个附近的农民用湖水浇灌庄稼。
And Maharaj Prithu was particularly expert in the worship of the Lord. He performed sacrifices for the pleasure of the Supreme Lord Vishnu.
普利图王尤其以崇拜主而建称，他为了取悦主为什么举行了种种的献祭仪式。
In the time of Maharaj Prithu, the people could perform sacrifices.
在普利图王的时代，人们是通过献祭来崇拜为什么。
And there were qualified brahmanas, just as we explained, the brahmanas were so powerful.That they could curse a person to die.
而且当时也有非常有资格的婆罗门，他们是如此有力量，以至于能够诅咒一个君王致死。
We know later on, even just before the Kali Yuga began, that Maharaj Parikshit was cursed by a Brahmin at the time.
我们也知道，在卡利年代，开始之前呢，马哈拉只 Parikshit 就是因为诅咒而死去的。
Not exactly a Brahmana, but he was the son of a Brahmana. He was the son of Samitarishi. And his name was Shringi. And he was a young boy. And he was proud of his Brahminical power.
诅咒培士大军的呢还不是一个婆罗门而是一个 Brahmana 的儿子 Shringi. 他的父亲是一位婆罗门但这个他的儿子特别骄傲。
And because of his foolish pride, he cursed Maharaj Parikshit to die.
由于他这个愚蠢的傲慢，他便诅咒了 Maharaj Parikshit.
He took offense to see Maharaj Parikshit put a dead snake around the neck of his father.
由于 Parikshit Maharaj 把一条死蛇挑起来放在他父亲的脖子上，所以他就被得罪了。
To show his Brahminical power to his other young friends, he said, just look at this Kshatriya king. He's so offensive to my father, who's a great Brahmana.
他就是为了向他的那些伙伴们展示他的婆罗门力量，他便说道，你看这个愚蠢的Kshatriya, 他竟然得罪了我的父亲的婆罗门。
So Maharaj Parikshit was certainly at fault.But his fault was not so serious that he had to be cursed to die.
Parikshit Maharaj 呢，肯定也犯了错误，但是不至于严重到应该被诅咒到死的地步。
But this young boy was proud of his Brahminical powers, and he wanted to show off his prowess.
但是这个年轻的小男孩被自己的婆罗门力量感到骄傲，他就想炫耀他的力量。
And so he cursed that this king will die 7 days from the bite of a snake bird.
他便诅咒说，这个国王在七天之内会由于一个蛇鸟被蛇鸟咬死。
And it came to pass. It actually happened. But of course, before that.Maharaj Parikshit was able to take advantage and to go and sit and hear Srimad Bhagavatam.
结果事实却真的发生了，但在此之前呢 ，Parikshit 大军呢就利用了这段时间坐下来聆听了圣严国家老台。
So the point here in this verse is that Maharaj Prithu, although he was given so much honor and respect.By all the citizens and brahmanas and priests in his capital, Maharaj Prithu did not become ever affected by the honor offered to him.
这个诗节的要点呢，就是尽管 Maharaj Prithu 王受到了臣民们、婆罗门和祭司们的赞扬，但他却丝毫不为所动。
He remained.Understood. He understood that the pride which was there, the respect which was being offered to him was not actually for him as a person, but it was for what he represented.
He 明白，就是他们这些人献给他的所有敬意呢，不是给他本人的，而是给他所代表这个事物。
And Prabhupada gives this famous example, which is common knowledge to people in the Vedic culture, about how a bamboo stick is very stiff and straight, doesn't bend.
圣巴巴德就举了一个，就是在伟大文化当中呢，广为人所知的例子，一根竹子，它是直挺挺的站在那里。
But the tree which has valuable fruits.The branches are bent and low.
但是结出那些有价值果实的果树却低垂着它们的树枝。
So in the same way, a person with good qualities will bow and will be humble, will not be proud.
拥有优秀品质的人呢，会顶礼，不会变得骄傲，而是谦卑。
But we do see sometimes people, just like sometimes people, they come to the temple, and, you know, they don't bow, they just come in and they just look around, and, you know, they don't offer any respects.
但是我们也见过这样的人，他们就径直走到庙里来，然后四下寻了一圈，然后根本就不会致敬。
Just like yesterday morning, some people came from Singapore.
昨天早上呢，有来自新加坡的人。
And I was puzzled, who were they? You know, I saw them come in, and they walked in, and you know, they're all very stiff and straight, and they just looked around, and they came in. But at the same time, you know, they were dressed as devotees.
我当时很纳闷，这些人从哪来的？因为他们直挺挺的，特别表情僵硬的走了进来，然后四下张望，但是他们的服装是见证者的服装。
And so then later on, Shiva Chaitanya came and told me that they're from the Ripik camp, the camp which doesn't follow the GBC.
然后庙长呢就告诉马拉雅说，这几个人是来自 Ritvik 阵营的，他们呢不遵循 GBC 的管理。
So they had that kind of appearance, you know, that they didn't show the humility, which is such an important quality of a devotee.
所以他们的模样就是这样的。没有展示出一个奉献者所应有的谦卑。
Chaitanya Charitamrita describes that we should take the third verse of the Shikshastikam and string it around our neck for constant remembrance.
Chaitanya Charitamrita 描述说，我们应该把祖的八行规的第三个诗节，把它就是恒常的像八环一样戴在我们的脖子上。
We should be tolerant like the tree and be devoid of false prestige.
像树一样宽容，没有虚荣感。
We should think of ourselves as lower than a straw in the street.
把自己当作比大街上的一个稻草还要低微。
So these two examples are very, very powerful for us to remember.
就这两个比喻呢，我们应该牢记，很重要。
Tolerant like the trees, just as we see the trees, they tolerate the heat, and they tolerate the wind and the rain, they tolerate all the conditions.
如树一样宽容，大树呢，他们会容忍狂风、暴雨、飓风。
People come and they can cut the branches, the tree will not protest.
有人过来呢，砍断树枝，他们也不会抗议。
But the tree will continue to offer flowers and fruits.
树木还会给人们提供鲜花果实。
And thinking of ourselves lower than a straw in the street means we should understand our spiritual dimension.
把自己视为比路边的一根茅草还要卑微，意思是说，我们应该牢记我们的灵性的尺寸大小。
That we're 1/10,000 of the tip of the hair.
我们只是发尖的万分之一那么大。
And if we're thinking of ourselves in terms of the body, then our ego will be like the body.
如果我们是以躯体化的概念想着自己，那我们的假自我就是跟我们的躯体成正比。
So false ego is to think I am the body.
假自我就会想我是这具躯体。
And that is the cause of our pride.
而这便导致我们会变得骄傲。
But if we understand our spiritual identity, then we'll have real ego, true ego, to understand ourselves as a servant of Krishna.
如果我们想着我们的灵性的尺寸大小，那我们就会明白，在灵性地位上，我们是 Krishna 的仆人。
So our ego should be in proportion to our spiritual dimension.
所以我们的自我呢，应该和我们灵性的大小而成正比。
Means we're very small and insignificant.
就意味着我们是非常的渺小、微不足道的。
And we offer all respects to others, and we're not anxious to take respect.
我们向其他人致敬，不渴望求得其他人的尊重。
In the Bhagavad Gita, 13th chapter.Lord Krishna lists different items of passion in knowledge.
我家梵歌第十三章，主 Krishna 列举了一个有知识的人的特点。
Very important. One more time, Shankaracharya came. He came in Hong Kong, and he was asking. He got a group of people and young men. He was asking them, "What is the first sign of knowledge?" Shankaracharya, yeah, present day Shankaracharya.
Oh, 就有一次呢，有一个当代的 Shankaracharya， 他就来到香港，然后有人就向他提出一个问题，一个有知识的人他是什么样的？
He was quoting from the Bhagavad Gita.
他便引述了佛家梵歌的这个诗节。
So in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna describes the first the qualities of one in knowledge.And the first qualities he mentions are amanitvam adambitvam, meaning humility and pridelessness.
所以主 Krishna 在第十四章、十三章便说了这个，就这两个梵文词，一个是就是没有骄傲，免于虚荣。
And Prabhupada explains that.And the purport Prabhupada explains that humility means one is not anxious to receive respect from others.
圣帕巴德在要旨当中说，谦卑的含义就是说不渴望得到其他人的尊敬。
Sometimes Srila Prabhupada will quote the English saying that pride comes before the fall.
有时候圣帕巴德会引述一个英语的谚语说。在一个人堕落之前呢，他首先变得骄傲了。
So that is something we should have to be very careful of. We don't want to be developing pride. Rather, we want to give up that pride.
所以我们对此要非常的小心。我们可不想变得骄傲，我们应该放弃这个傲慢。
At the same time, we want to have pride.In the fact that we are a devotee of Krishna.
与此同时呢，我们应该为自己是 Krishna 的奉献者而感到自豪。
Our pride should not be in the material body.
我们的自豪感啊，应该是源于我们的物质躯体。
We should have some pride in the fact that we have an opportunity to do service for Lord Krishna.
我们应该为有机会能够为圣主 Krishna 做服务而感到自豪。
We should think of ourselves as fortunate to have that opportunity.
我们应该认为有这种机会呢是鸿运当头，走运了。
Not everybody appreciates the opportunity to do service for the Lord.
并不是每个人都能欣赏到能够为主从事服务的这个良机。
There are many devotees around this area here, but we don't see them come to the temple except when there's a big festival.
在这个地区呢，也有很多的奉献者，但平常我们见不到的身影，只有在大节日才能看见他们。
Maybe tomorrow there'll be more people, there'll be more activity. Tomorrow's an auspicious day.
也许明天，这个吉祥的日子会有。
Tomorrow is Ekadasi, and it's also the day in which Lord Krishna speaks the Bhagavad Gita.
明天既是 Ekadasi， 也是圣主 Krishna 讲述佛家梵歌的降临日。
Sometimes they call it Gita Jayanti.
有时候他们称之为 Gita Jayanti.
And by tradition, the devotees.Will arrange to recite the whole Bhagavad Gita in the course of the day.
按照传统呢，奉献者们会安排这一整日，吟诵整部国家梵歌。
So we can also try to organize to recite the Bhagavad Gita tomorrow.
我们也可以努力的去组织明天来吟诵国家梵歌诗节。
And because it's ecology, we want to do more hearing and chanting.
因为是 ecology 日，我们希望能够更多的聆听唱诵。
Srila Prabhupada stressed those two things on ecology and on any festival.
Srila Prabhupada在 ecology 和任何节日上都强调这个聆听唱诵。
Srila Prabhupada was not much concerned about devotees fasting, but he liked them to do more hearing and chanting.
对于奉献者戒食这件事呢，石头爸爸并不是很 在意，但是他更关心的是奉献者应该去聆听、唱诵。
And chanting means we should try, we want to chant with the mode of pure devotion.
吟诵吟唱就意味着我们怀着纯粹的奉爱去吟诵吟唱。
So the first quality is to understand I'm not the body, that I'm a tiny, insignificant servant of Lord Krishna.
首要的资格就是明白我不是这一具躯体，而是圣主 Krishna 的非常渺小的、微不足道的仆人。
Even though Maharaj Prithu was such a great personality.Although he was worshipped by so many great persons, he never allowed it to affect him.
甚至像慧主王这样伟大的人物受到人们这么多的崇拜，他也丝毫不为所动。
And by his worship, he was able to attract Lord Vishnu into the arena of sacrifice.
慧主王的崇拜甚至吸引了主威士努显现在祭祀场。
Of course, in the Kali Yuga, we only perform one sacrifice.
当然，在卡利年代呢，我们只从事一种祭祀。
That is Sankirtan.
就是齐颂圣名记。
Kali Yuga Dharma, Harinam, Sankirtan. The religious principles in the Kali Yuga are enacted by Sankirtan, by the chanting of the holy name.
卡里年代的宗教是就是齐颂主的圣名。
We encourage people to chant the holy name, and we also chant the holy name ourselves.
我们不仅鼓励别人念诵唱诵圣名，我们自己也亲力亲为。
So we want to show people that example. When people come to the temple.They want to see Kirtan. They want to hear the holy name.
我们想要向世人做一个榜样，当他们来到庙里的时候，他们就可以聆听到 Kirtan 圣名。
We know in Mayapur and in Vrindavan, there's Akhanda Kirtan. It means the Kirtan is going on 24 hours every day.
我们知道在 Mayapur 和 Vrindavan 有 Akhanda Kirtan， 他们每天呢都有不间断的 Kirtan。
And Lord Chaitanya has also told us, Kirtani Yasa Dahari, always chant the holy name.
主 Chaitanya 也训斥我们要 Kirtani Yasa Dahari, 恒常的唱诵主的圣名。
Of course, other services have to be done. We have to cook, we have to clean, we have to do laundry.
当然我们也有其他的服务要烹饪，要清洁，要洗衣服。
But at the same time, we can also be chanting. We want to practice remembering the holy name.
做这些事情的时候，我们都可以在练习着 Kirtan， 恒常的意念主。
And the more we keep the holy name on our tongue, then the more we can protect ourselves from becoming proud.
我们越是能够让我们的圣名在我们的舌尖上。我们就能越是保护自己免于傲慢。
So the material energy is very powerful. We have to always be on guard.
物质能量是如此的强大，我们要时刻保持警惕。
Prabhupada told the story about the little mouse who came to the yogi and told the yogi that, "Oh, yogi." There's a cat chasing me. Please save me.
他爸讲了一个故事，有一只小老鼠来到一个瑜伽师面前诉苦说，瑜伽师啊，有一只猫在追我。
So the yogi said to the mouse, what do you want? And the mouse said, can you make me a cat? So the yogi said, all right, become a cat.
瑜伽师就问小老鼠说，那好吧，那你想要什么呀？小老鼠说，请您把我变成一只猫吧。瑜伽师说，那好，你就变成猫。
And so the cat went away, but after some time, cat came back and said,Oh, Yogi, now a dog is chasing me.
过了段时间呢，这只变成猫的老鼠又来到瑜伽师面前诉苦说，哎，现在有一条狗总是追我。
So Yogi said, okay, then you become a dog.
瑜伽师就摆摆手说，好吧，那你也变成条狗。
And then after some time, then the dog came back again and said, a tiger is chasing me.
过了一段时间，这条狗又来到瑜伽师面前说，现在有一头老虎，它总是在追逐。
So Yogi said, oh, you want to become a tiger also? He said, okay, become a tiger.
瑜伽师就说，你是不是也想变成一头老虎呢？那好吧，你就变成老虎。
But then when the tiger sat in front of the yogi,Then the tiger was licking his lips and thinking, I will eat the yogi. But the yogi could understand, oh, you want to eat me?
可是这头老虎呢，它虎视眈眈地坐在瑜伽师面前，就舔着自己的嘴唇。瑜伽师就说，你竟然想吃我。
Again, you become a mouse.
好吧，就变回那个小老鼠。
So this is called Punar Mustika Baba. Again become a mouse.
这句话意思是说，再次变回老鼠。
So people also go through these kind of changes. See? Become big, become a big person, and then they become a small person.
人们也会有这样的转变。他们变成大人物之后呢，随后又变回了默默无闻的小人物。
Krishna, the Lord has 10 arms. The 10 arms, if he wants, he can give everything or he can take it.
主有十个臂膀，他用十个臂膀可以把一切能拿走，也可以给你很多。
We only have 2 arms, so difficult for us.
而我们呢，只有两臂，所以对我们就很难。
But if we surrender to the Lord, He can give everything.
倘若我们向主臣服，他就可以给你一切。
We have to use it carefully in the Lord's service.
我们要小心的把主给予我们的用来服务主。
So we must always be very careful. To guard against false pride.
我们要时刻保持警觉，小心虚荣感。
And that pride then is the identifying, first of all, thinking, I am the body, and because I am the body, I am the enjoyer.
这种骄傲首先是来自于这种想法，我是这个躯体。因为我是这一具躯体，所以我可以去享受。
You want to remember our spiritual identity by always chanting the holy name.
所以我们要恒常的唱诵圣名，来铭记自己的灵性的身份。
Okay, are there any questions?
有没有问题？
是吗？是徐德涛他说他特别的骄傲，因为他说我因为我是昆山出生，我感到骄傲。有的时候我们也感到骄傲，我们因为我们今生遇到了徐德涛他，遇到了一场遇到昆山之友，我们感到骄傲。请问这个骄傲和我们今天这个骄傲有什么区别？
Srila Prabhupada said that I'm very proud of I'm the servant of Krishna. And sometimes we feel very proud that we are fortunate, we are lucky that we have met Srila Prabhupada's movement and met ISKCON. So what's the base of pride compared with the pride we mentioned today?
The pride we mentioned today is thinking I'm the body and thinking this is the, everything I've done by my own efforts.
我们今天讲到这种骄傲呢，是就认为我是这个身体，而且一切呢都是我做的。
But the pride which is described by Srila Prabhupada, by the pride of being a devotee, that is pride in getting the mercy of Guru and Krishna.
但是圣帕巴德他在这里所说的自豪感，这种骄傲，是因为就得到了。Guru and Krishna
的仁慈。By their mercy only, we've got that, we've come to this position to be devotees.
之所以我们现在成为了奉献者，取得这样的地位，都是 Guru and Krishna 的仁慈导致的。
So we consider ourselves to be very fortunate to have received the mercy of Guru and Krishna.
所以我们认为，得到了 Guru and Krishna 的仁慈，我们是特别的走运的。
So pride in being a recipient of the mercy of Guru and Krishna.
我们因为我们成为了 Guru Krishna 的仁慈的接受者，这个容器，我们感到非常的由衷的自豪和骄傲。
But material pride is thinking, I did this by my efforts, by my own endeavor.
物质的骄傲呢，是认为我靠我自己的努力，我取得了这样的成功。
Okay. Any other question?
还有其他问题吗？
So the question is, in the practice of bhakti, sometimes even though a person has not achieved perfection himself, but because he has pleased his special master, sadhu, is it possible, he's taken back to Godhead by these people? And my second question is,How does austerity help us to progress on the spiritual path? 我的问题是，如果一个人他自身还没有抵达完美，但是如果他取悦了一个圣人或者他的灵性导师，是否意味着他可能被这些人带回灵性世界呢？然后第二个问题就是，苦行是如何帮助我们在灵性道路上进步的？
I forget the first question again.Oh yes, right. Yeah. The person hasn't achieved perfection himself, can the spiritual master take him back to Godhead? Well, no. You have to have some qualification to go back to Godhead. The qualification is...First of all, that you have to surrender to the Lord.
那回归神手呢？需要具备资格。第一条资格呢，就是首先要向主臣服。
Initiation, accepting the spiritual master initiation, that is just the beginning of the process.
启迪就是从一位灵性导师那里获得启迪，这是灵修的开端。
We get people like that sometimes. They think, now I'm initiated, now I'm already can go back to Godhead.
我们 也遇到过这样的人，他心想，我现在启迪了，我可以回到神手那里。
No, it's not so simple. You have to follow the process.
事情不是那么简单，还得按照程序来。
Srila Prabhupada said,I am doing the ritual of initiation. Now it's up to you to practice the process.
释迦帕帕德以前说过，我现在只是举行了启迪的这个仪式。现在呢，是取决于你们是否来遵循这个程序和道路。
You have to practice.
你们还得去练习灵修。
Of course, we do have some examples about. In Srimad Bhagavatam, we have the example how Dhruva Maharaj's mother was taken back to Godhead by Dhruva Maharaj.
当然，在圣贤国大堂当中也有这样的例子。朱瓦玛哈拉的母亲是被朱瓦玛哈拉带回的世界的。
So Dhruva Maharaj was going to Vaikuntha. The airplane came from Vaikuntha to take him, but he said, "Wait, I can't go without my mother because she was the one who inspired me in the beginning. She told me to go to the forest and I'd find God there." But then he told her, Dhruva Maharaj, "No, your mother is also going. There's another airplane taking her."
当朱瓦玛哈拉准备回到Vaikuntha的时候呢？甚至百分他来了一架飞机接迎接他，而朱瓦玛哈拉说，等等，我得把我的母亲也一起带回去。然后百分的使者就告诉他说，你的母亲已经乘坐了另一架百分的飞机回去了。
So this example of Dhruva Maharaj's mother, she went back to Godhead. Prabhupada said, by the mercy of my disciples, I hope one of them will also take me back to Godhead.
圣巴巴德在要旨当中呢，就涉及到这个例子的时候，他在要旨当中说，我希望我的其中一位门徒也能把我带回神城那里。
So the disciple can take the guru back to Godhead.
所以门徒也可以把孤独带回神手那里。
You want the guru to take you back to Godhead.
你希望孤独把你带回神手那里。
Guru wants the disciple to take him back to God.
孤独还指望门徒把他带回神手那里。
Right? You want that kind of disciple who will take you back to Godhead.
是吗？你也希望得到这样一个门徒，能把你带回神圣那里的门徒。
Don't just want a disciple. Oh, I'll take the disciple back to God. Oh, no. Forget it. I don't want that kind of disciple.
灵性导师不想要这种，就一心指望着灵性导师能把他带回，指望灵性导师能把他带回神圣那里。
You want to go back to Godhead, you have to work, you have to be pure, you have to purify yourself, you have to practice the process.
你想回到神圣那里，必须得努力工作，净化自己，遵随按照程序来。
Bhana Swami is talking, we have to develop praying.
Bhana Swami 是说我们，他讲课时说我们要发展起 praying。
And so then you ask about austerity. What is the relevance of austerity in the practice of devotional service? So by practicing devotional service, one will automatically acquire two things, knowledge, jnana, and vairagya, detachment from the world.
你要问说苦行在灵修当中的作用地位。我们通过从事奉献服务，自动就培养出两项品质 ：vairagya（ 气节）以及知识。
So jnana and vairagya, they automatically follow where there is genuine devotion.
哪里有真诚的奉爱，哪里就有知识和气节。
One who is devoted will naturally practice some austerity, just like austerity means.The Ekadasi, observing the Ekadasi vows strictly, and then also austerities in chanting the holy name and studying scriptures and performing the different angas of bhakti.
一位奉献者呢，会就从事这样的苦行，他遵守 Ekadasi 的誓言，他唱诵圣名，他研习书籍，他也。去从事奉献服务的不同的这个安岗分支。
Austerity. Sometimes people don't like to bow down. They don't like to come to temple and offer obeisances. But Prabhupada said, well, if you don't bow down to Krishna, then you will bow down to old age, disease, and death.
有的人呢不想去做这种磕头顶拜的这种苦行。圣帕巴德说如果不向 Krishna 臣服， 那就得向老年疾病和死亡磕头。
But the devotees are joyful in bowing down before Krishna. But the materialists are not joyful in bowing down to old age, disease, and death.
奉献者向 Krishna 顶拜的时候，内心是怀着喜悦；但是非奉献者、物质主义者呢，向老年、疾病、死亡，顶拜的时候，可并不是那么乐意的。
And so austerity is a pleasure in Krishna consciousness.
苦行在 Krishna 知觉当中是一项可气的快乐。
Giving up sinful activities to take up purifying activities.
放弃了罪恶的活动，去从事纯净的活动。
Giving up eating garbage food to eat spiritually nourishing food.
去放弃吃那些垃圾食品，而转而去荣耀灵性的有营养的灵性食物。
Some people think, oh, life of a Krishna conscious devotee is very austere. But other people think for the life of a devotee is simply recreation, simply joyful.
有些人认为呢，奉献者的生活太苦行了，而有的其他人会认为奉献的生活非常喜乐的。
So austerities of the body, mind, and words are described in the Bhagavad Gita.Lord Krishna describes, for example, austerity in words is reciting scriptures.
佛家梵歌呢描述了有躯体、心意、言语的苦行，而言语的苦行之一呢就是吟诵经典。
So we want to do that tomorrow. We want to recite the Bhagavad Gita.
我们明天呢就想从事这个苦行来吟诵吟唱佛家梵歌。
Tomorrow is the day Krishna spoke the Bhagavad Gita in Kurukshetra more than 5,000 years ago.
在5000年前，圣子 Krishna 在 Kurukshetra 战场上讲述了佛家梵歌。
That is an austerity in speech. Another austerity in speech is speaking words which are pleasing to others.
这是其中一项苦行，而言语的另一项苦行是。言语宜人悦人
，and speaking words which are truthful，
说话真诚。
People find it very difficult to be truthful in this age。
在这个年代呢，人们觉得，说话真诚很难。
So much lying and cheating goes on everywhere。
人到处呢都会发现人们在撒谎欺骗。
So that is the austerity, and this is part of the austerity of being a devotee.
这是作为奉献者的苦行的一部分。
But austerities which torture the body are, then that is simply the mode of passion and ignorance.
但是那些折磨躯体的那些无谓的苦行呢，那是处在愚昧和激情形态的。
Just like in a few weeks, there's a big festival here called Thai Pusam, when people worship Murga, the son of Lord Shiva, who is also called Kartikeya.
过几周呢，在这个地方有一个盛大的节日，人们会崇拜主 Shiva 的儿子 Kartikeya.
It's a big holiday here for several days.Thousands of people all come to the temple and to see the different sights.
这个是连续几天的节日，有成千上万的人都会来到这个地方。
Either at Batu Caves and near KL, there's a big temple there where thousands of people go at that time every year.
在那个黑风洞就有很多的人去黑风洞。
And also up here at Penang, over at Penang, there's a famous Murga temple. And the devotees all go and they'll distribute books and prasadam and preach.
在槟城附近的那个 Murga 庙呢，你奉献者会去那里就派prasadam和书籍。
So you can see a lot of austerities done. Some people walk on shoes of nails.
有的人穿的鞋的是钉子鞋。
Have you ever walked on a nail?
你们有没有走过就是赤脚走在钉子上？
It's not very easy.
特别的疼痛。
But some people do it, carrying the milk to bathe the deity, they walk on these shoes with upturned nails.
有的人他们就手里拿着牛奶罐，就穿着鞋子，他这个鞋底是钉子做的。
And then they pierce their bodies with hooks.
他们还用钩子穿他们的身体。
And they will put something, sometimes they put something right through their cheek, a long metal rod which goes right through the cheek.
有些人呢，他们用一根长长的铁棍把他们这个下颚穿透。
And in this way, this is their austerity.
这就是他们的苦行。So
that kind of austerity, that is in the mode of ignorance.
这是愚昧心态的苦行。But
people, they will make these vows, you know, that they'll vow to their wife or something that they'll do this.
有的人呢会向妻子发下这种毒誓。
So thousands of people come and they carry a big kaberi.
他们并没有念唱主的名字。It's
all worship in the mode of ignorance.
这是愚昧形态的崇拜。And
passion.
激情的崇拜。So
our austerity is in the mode of goodness.
我们的苦行是处在善良心态。Means
doing things like fasting on the Ekadasi, not taking the grains and beans.
我们的苦行就是在一卡的昔日呢，不吃五谷。And
reciting scriptures.
以及吟诵唱经典。Chanting
the holy name.
我们会吟诵唱圣名。
And if you distribute books, that's also a great austerity, to go out and preach to people.
如果派书也是一项了不起的苦行，就外出向人们传播。
You want to do austerity? Take some books and go out and try to preach, try to give the holy name to people.
倘若你想做苦行的话，就拿这样几本书。 外出呢，向人们传教，让他们唱诵圣名。That
is a greater austerity than any of these yogis.
这比任何一个瑜伽师，这种瑜伽师做的苦行都要伟大。So,
of course, if you've never been on book distribution, you don't know what is that austerity.
如果没有从事过派书的话，就不知道这种苦行的滋味。
But some, of course, at Rathiatra, when the devotees were, when we were over in Penang, devotees were distributing books, and Chinese devotees brought some books with them, and they were distributing them to people.
我们在槟城过团车节的时候呢，中国奉献者就从中国带了书籍，就在那里也向我们派书。
So they got a little taste of Sankirtan.
他们就对桑提尔塔有了一点的品味。So that
is an austerity which is very purifying to give Krishna consciousness to others.
这种苦行呢是有净化力的，这种把Krishna智觉给其他人的苦行是有净化力的。And
Srila Prabhupada wanted all of us to get that experience.
Srila Prabhupada 希望我们都能获得这样的体验。He
knew it would purify all of us.
他知道我们这能净化我们所有人。Okay.
We're getting very late, so better stop here. Srimad Bhagavatam ki
jai. Jai.